Hi, this is Scott Hanselman. I'm taking a look at some of the CSS editing features in Visual Studio 2013. I actually went and grabbed an example from CSS Deck from a gentleman named Marco Biederman. This is just a little bit of HTML showing some social networks and then some CSS to back it up. And it kind of looks like this. You'll notice that they spin when you go over them, which is kind of nice. You've got some CSS animations there. But let's say we want to rotate these. We want these to actually be like this by default. So I'll come in here to my CSS, and you notice that I've got some vendor-specific transition things here for Opera, Microsoft, WebKit, everybody. And I'm just going to go and type in transform and then hit tab, you see? And then I'll start typing rotate. I'm getting IntelliSense at every step here. And then I'm going to rotate that 45 degrees and then hit enter. And you'll see that that actually propagated to all the different vendor-specific prefixes. Hit save and come over here and hit refresh. And there we go. So now we've got the social stuff turned and then also transitioning. So inside of the CSS editor, we've got the vendor-specific IntelliSense. We've also got pseudo-selector IntelliSense. So if I came out here, for example, and let's say I wanted a hover state, I hit colon, and we get the pseudo-elements and pseudo-selectors, as well as IntelliSense and tips on those and what we're going to do. And then if I wanted to go and change, for example, the color, I could pick all the regular word colors, but I could also, let's say, pick some kind of a hex color. Everything from the left of that bar there is actually one of the colors that already exists in this document. So Marco Biederman, who created this CSS, has selected these colors as the standard colors, and I can go and pick those. But I could also open this up and have a color picker, or I could pick the eyedropper and say I wanted this color purple down here and pick that as well. So that's pretty slick. We've got IntelliSense and snippets for lots of things that you type all the time, like media tab, see? Or let's say fonts. Fonts is a real hassle, font face. There you go. So working with CSS3 is really comfortable in 2013, from colors to fonts to vendor-specific IntelliSense, snippets, pseudo-selectors. It's really convenient. And it's also made even better when you go and get Visual Studio Web Essentials. You go up to vswebessentials.com, and this is our labs. This is where we play. And in here, you'll get even more extensions to Visual Studio 2012 and 2013 with hover states that show you what browser supports what feature. It's really, really great. It's free. You can go and check that out at vswebessentials.com. And we'll continue to move those new features from Web Essentials into the core product, like this one here, which is Visual Studio 2013. Thanks a lot.